So let's take a look at the term bandwidth. Undoubtedly this is a term that you've heard before, but maybe you haven't thought about exactly what it means. And a lot of people do misuse it. So what bandwidth really is amount of data over time. In that way it's kind of similar to when you say speed, which is a lot of the reason why we sometimes use the word speed instead of bandwidth. Speed is distance over time and bandwidth is data over time. So let's take a look at some speeds that we've dealt with in the past. Dial-up modems, if you remember those, usually ran around 56 kilobits per second. So that's kilo as in thousand of bits, and bits are either ones or zeros, per second. And that's the speed that we had of transferring data using modems. If you use Ethernet cables to connect computers, as we did before, Wi-Fi, then you were usually doing speeds about 10 megabits per second. So megabits being 1,000 kilobits, and you're doing 10 of those on old-style Ethernet. Ethernet then went to 100 megabits per second, and it's now at 1,000 megabits per second typically. But usually we use Wi-Fi nowadays to network our computers, and that runs at about 600 megabits per second. That's using 802.11n. Older versions of Wi-Fi will be slower, and newer versions will be even faster than that. Now, if you're using mobile phones and mobile connection, then you might be using an LTE network, which is typically the faster networks now, and they run at 12 megabits per second. But 5G, which is in the future, will be running many times faster than that, some estimated at around 490 megabits per second. So almost as fast as Wi-Fi in our homes from computer to computer. So that gives you some idea of what we're talking about. Now let's take a look at these units just so you understand them. You know, kilobits per second, sometimes using kbps, especially when talking about mobile, you know, that's 1,000 bits, and a bit is a 1 or a 0. Megabit is 1,000 times that. Now a lot of times when you have 1,000 megabits per second, providers like to call that gigabit, although my provider calls 100 megabits per second gigabit Ethernet or gigabit bandwidth. Just to give you an idea of what that really means is every byte has 8 bits, and we usually do a byte as a single character, like a letter in a word processing document. An image file typically averages around 2 megabytes, so 2 million bytes. So you can kind of figure how long it would take to download. It takes a fraction of a second over a gigabit connection, for instance, to download an image. You know, maybe a second or so over mobile to, you know, a full high resolution image. A lot of times when we see images nowadays online, they're not full high resolution. The ones, you know, you actually take with your camera, they're kind of optimized and much smaller for the web or for viewing in different apps. Now, there's a lot of difference between engineering and marketing when it comes to this. We've so far been talking about engineering terms, but marketing will sometimes fudge these numbers. For instance, they'll use for a kilobit 1,000 instead of 1,024. They'll round up a lot. And very often they'll do things like say you have 100 megabit connection, but that's only downloading things. Uploading things sometimes are a lot smaller, and they kind of get away with this with marketing. An engineer wouldn't say that. An engineer would specify up and down speeds, but marketing will just kind of give you the larger one. And of course marketing also uses speeds up too. So you may have promised to you 100 megabits per second, but in fact that's just the maximum you can get, and very often you're at a fraction of that depending upon use in your neighborhood and conditions and things like that. Also, net neutrality comes into this a little bit, because sometimes you deal with issues like you may find that video stream really great from services like Netflix and Hulu and such that pay a little extra to have their streams go really fast. But then from other sites or when transferring files yourself, you may find it's a lot slower. So sometimes networks will actually put things in faster lanes and slower lanes. Now, people often confuse bandwidth with other things. One thing, for instance, is throughput. Throughput is kind of like average speed. So your average speed might be your throughput, but your actual speed, your bandwidth, is what you have right now. So your bandwidth right now may be slower than normal, but your throughput's just basically your average. Now the biggest confusion is when people say bandwidth, what they mean is data transfer. So you, for instance, you'll say, "I'm out of bandwidth with my mobile plan," or I've reached my bandwidth limit or something like that. And that's actually incorrect. That's actually talking about the amount of data transferred. It's like saying distance. Like you might have enough fuel in your car to go 300 miles, but you wouldn't say that's a limit on your speed. You would say that's a limit on your distance, just as these limits are limits on your data transfer, not limits on your bandwidth. So don't use the term bandwidth when actually talking about data limits.